Hey guys, Nick here today, and welcome to the block switcher, the block switcher. Now, basically, what I started with was how could I press a button and have the blocks go out, and then switch and come back out, and, well, my first try, as you may be able to see, it's kind of bad. I arranged it so that it could switch to these iron blocks, but my whole redstone was just messed up. The second one, I made a bit more successful. First thing, you press a button to switch the block, then you flick a switch, it'll use the selected block. It works for both. But then I was like, what if you want to use lighting in a room, and you want it gridded, such as this, so that you could make it so that it does that, switches from, you know, dark colors to lighter colors. Now, I just used the lapis here. You're probably going to want to use the same thing so you could disguise it, but I just used it to help stick it out and whatnot, and it just occurred to me in this episode that I should probably be building the things over separate after I talk about them, and I most likely will start doing that, just not now. I don't have enough time. I did have enough time to do it as I started the first video, but when I started it, I messed up, and then I realized I had too many pistons and too many blocks. So, all I needed was a grid, but I was making an entire box filled with, I could have had spaces in between, but I didn't. Anyway, basically, you press it, it goes out. You press it, switches blocks. You press it again, it'll go out, and you could just basically do that so you can illuminate a room or change how the room style is. You know, maybe if you're feeling one mood today, you'll switch it to a red carpet. You're feeling a different mood, you'll switch it to blue carpet. And another reason the lapis is here so that I can take out this real quick. Oh no, to show you the inner workings of this, and then I'll show you the actual redstone part of it. But for now, I want to show how the block switch works, because it might not work how you would think it works, because at first I thought it would, you know, just switch and then switch back exactly. It might actually do that. Okay, so see, I push that down to make a full line. It does that. I'm pretty sure all it does is push it back up. Yeah, push it back up. I mean, this isn't even needed. I wonder if it would work if I took that out, and if I took this out. Would it still work? Let's test that out. Of course, that's gonna work. But the rest? Yeah, to make a grid, you only need two sides, as long as you're changing it. And as long as you only need to change, you know, that is right? And then you push this and it fixes itself. That's easier than I thought. I was messing around with so much redstone before and creating so many things, but alas, all I need is easiness. See, it's a good reason. I mean, it's kind of a good thing that I messed up on my other one, or else I wouldn't have noticed that I need less pistons than I was putting. Half as much, actually, because I think I was putting, yeah, double the amount with the spaces in between covering. And then now I notice that I only need 8 pistons total, 2 to push, 2 to do that. I could even take out this, and it would still... Oh, not that. Sorry. This, and it would still work perfectly. Let's double check that. Right? It doesn't use it at all. It pushes it and changes it. You push it. Switches. You can push it back. And all you have to do is cover up the grid area. For this case, I'm going to be using lapis to do this, so as to not ruin any of the effects, or so that if I ever want to know where the holes are, it's easier to find out. And I'm pretty sure with this, your lapis is more of a number, an ampersand, I guess. No, I guess it's less because it has a middle line. And anyway, yeah, no lights. Lights. Magic. So let me first show how it works. Now you're probably going to want to get this out and in first before you get the switch blocks, because you can't switch it unless you pull it out. So first things first, it just sends a signal over to here. Instead of doing all of this, okay, you'll still need the signal to move out, but basically what this is I believe a T flip-flop. What it does is when you press it, it blinks these or whatever and makes it switch no matter what. Switch, it will keep going back and forth every time you press it. I could press it up close right here. You can see it changes, and it does in fact change that. You press it again, it changes. So yeah, as you can see, that's what the T flip-flop does. It's just this and then this. I'm pretty sure you could place a block there, but you could also make redstone be going there, you know. Doesn't matter which side you place a torch on, but you have to place a torch below the two, and that's the T flip-flop. I show it in my Everything You Need to Know About Redstone, I believe, at least, I do. It just lets you turn on and off things using a button instead of a lever, and it can be useful for other things. If you have things that turn on other things, for example. Then this just carries a signal, of course, and you could also use repeaters here. I just changed it later in mid building phase because of a glitch that was happening. Anyway, it just sends the signal to all of them. There are redstone torches under the pistons, making it so that when the signal isn't going, they'll push up. When the signal is going, they'll push down. And the T flip flop controls the signal. So yeah. Now, the more complicated of it, I may want to take this in case I accidentally use the T flip-flops there or something like that. The switch blocks. Now, this one is a bit more complicated. I think I already said that once. Actually, it's basically just like two of that. First one, going over, you have to have the same amount of repeaters on either side or else, you know, it'll screw up. But T flip-flop with the signal going out to this side, and then an inverted, this just basically is just the pathway of redstone. You come over here, have the inverted, see this one's off and this one is on, clearly. So you invert it by either pressing it or switching the side the torch is on or something like that. And then that's it. You set up pistons to push, and then you have to have it opposite. Not sure why this isn't pushing. When you push the button, though, it will change, as you can see. It might be glitched like that, though, not showing it actually moving until it actually moves. But yeah, that's basically it. Switches. Out and in. Switch blocks. Out and in. Now, I will be showing how to build this in a different episode, but it won't be this. It'll be so you only have one button, or maybe as you open the door, it'll activate, so you don't have to worry about that. But that's about all for this episode. I mean, the contraption's pretty simple in itself. You just need two T flip-flops, or three if you're not going to use a lever. Because as you can see over here, I used lever. I'm just going to call it whenever. I use a lever, and that works just as good. In fact, it takes less of the repeaters. Actually, never mind. It just takes less time to switch, and you don't hear as much piston noise. You know, like a chk, and then a chk. You just hear a chk, or a chk. Okay, that was me trying to make piston noises. I can't. No, I don't know how it goes. But yeah, see, it's getting so late that I'm getting crazy. making piston noises. Wait, was that close? Shh, no. Whoosh. Okay, sorry. I'll stop now. But yeah, just 2T flip-flops, 3 if you're not using a lever. The third one is just basically gonna go to this. You need to place your first block to 3 layers away from the top, and then you just need to place that block 3 away from another. So block 3 block, and then if you're gonna make extend it out even more, you could wait another 3 to make it a block. That's if you're gonna do a double, of course. I'm pretty sure you would still do it 3 over. I mean, a space of 3 between. But at total, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or at least 4 away. Because 5 minus 1 is 4. And that's the range. I don't know. But yeah, just two. First T flip-flop just goes through, activates all of these, and makes it on a button so you could change it. Now, second one. Second and third, as said, just go to it, activate it, send the pistons to move out, or to pull back in, and then just an inverted one doing the exact same thing. So it's not too complicated. It's a pretty easy build if you use your brain. If not, it could take you like 3 hours, like it did for me, to revise everything and get it to where it actually works the most efficiently. It doesn't take too much redstone, and it's pretty cool. You could build cool rooms with it. You could probably attach it to like a door, so when you right-click the door, it'll activate. I'm not sure if doors can send through signals. If they're open, I think if they're closed, they can send a signal, but if they're open, they can't. Not too sure. Or you could just have an iron door with a button, and when you press the button, it delays, lets you walk in, and then it goes The only problem is the out and in. There's 2 buttons, and no one's gonna want to press 2 buttons to open the door. So that's why next in our first Let's Build episode of the redstone, of me actually showing off the redstone, I will be making it a 1 button mechanism. We're already 12 minutes in here, so I think it's a good place to stop. This is the same thing, basically, just... this one only... Oh, wait! I was doing both of these in the time of 3 hours. Ha. I started this at the beginning of Limitless. Let's see. I got to the part where... He goes back for more. The guy gets shot. I started building this, and I was like, I'll show this off. And then I was like, wait a minute. Full room floor grid. Yes. Sorry, the rain's coming from there, right next to the desert. But I hope you enjoyed, and next episode will be another cool contraption. Let's just review the 5 contraptions. I think it's 5 I have so far. There's the interchangeable floor, the timed time bomb, the wishy-wishy diagonal piston pusher, the piston elevator, and the super piston door, double piston door. I mean, you could make it a lot more simple than this, but this is a pretty cool way. See, it pulls that out, pushes it to the side. That's why I think it's cool, because in other ones, it would just pull the block away, and it would cover it, which makes it more disguised. But this one looks cool. It makes it shows that you put in a lot of work. And Enderman. Dang, I honestly can't find where what the Enderman did. I know he did something because he did it to it once already, right here. Sneaky. Never mind. This is why you build it on enderproof blocks. Let's just see how this goes real quick. If I press the button, that will do its opening routine. And if I press the button, oh, what is happening? What the heck? Man, my mouse, man. Okay, good, still recording. I believe it's this. Not working. As per usual. Wait, that's not per usual. Ah, what is this doing here? Why is there a random torch there? The T flip flop is broken. Honestly. Okay, this random torch probably doesn't help it too much. Oh, never mind. No, that does do the right thing. Okay. I'm afraid that if I press this, it's gonna explode. No, the T flip flop's all screwed up for some unknown reason. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I think it's trying to close and open at the same time. Oh shoot. Well, I'm gonna have to fix this later. This isn't even about this, so I don't know why I'm going into it. Oh gosh. Oh! That's why. Why is it all the way? How did it even get over there? Oh my god, what is happening? Where is all of this coming from? Okay, there should be one there, and then I can make two in here. And that'll be great. Let's see how this works. Sorry. If you were only interested in the other thing, you would have left by now anyway. Ta-da! But anyway, just the simplicity of a little door, but making it so that it has a special, you know, opening instead of just up and down, like a lot of other things do. This isn't really a foreshadowing of next episode of Everything You Need to Know About Redstone, because I may actually abandon that series unless I can find a partner / tutor teacher. And I can do a lot of redstone circuits. I know pretty much all of it now. I could do a ton of things with redstone. It's just I need a teacher for all this binary stuff so I can make a calculator computer thingy. Just because if you're gonna learn it, why not learn it all? Mm-hmm. Logic, man. Anyway, see you next episode, and I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something from this, as that is the goal of these videos, to teach you something or show you how to build a cool little thingy. Next time I want to build probably like something where it's like chests that cycle through. So it's like a circle of chests, and the pitcher pushes it out and up, and then you could check that chest, and then you press it and it goes ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch and switches, or you press a button and then it like cycles through, or you press a lever and then it'll keep cycling through until you get to the chest you want, and then you turn it off. But maybe along with the chest, it could also like push out a piece, like it could cycle through gold, iron, or any color of wool, so you know what kind of chest it is. So that's what I'm hoping to build in next episode. If it gets too complicated, it'll probably be something else, or if I get a motivation for something else, it will be something else. Then I'll see you then. I really have